definitely more possibilities for roles, but it's also, it's an interesting thing because there is so much more being created, and so that the possibilities of different kinds of roles are expanding. And at the same time, you know, a lot of movie stars are moving to TV, and because shows are miniseries or they're 10 episodes, a lot of the same actors are like, hey, I'll do two or three shows. And so it's expanding, but there's also that, you know, it's just a competitive industry, and there's always going to be that kind of, you know, even though there's more happening, there's some of the same people doing more things, and they're not locked into one show for 10 months a year. They're able to do two or three shows, and why not if you can, you know? So it's really an interesting time because it is, there's so many platforms, and you're like, okay, there's, even coming here, I'm like, oh gosh, they're like, hello. Like, there's so many different things that people are working on. So hopefully that translates into lots of new opportunities for everyone here, myself included. In general, there's this immediate gratification that's in part due to the technology moving more quickly than the human brain at this point. And I think people want to watch one episode of a show and be locked in, and they know it's going to be good. And sometimes it takes a while for writers to figure out what works. And especially with comedy, I would think that's even harder. You know, it's such a, you know, comedic sensibilities are so individualistic. So I think that does make it harder. And people just want to sit down over a weekend and see 10 episodes and see a character's arc from beginning to end. They're interested in how that narrative plays out from an individual perspective. And it's so rewarding to watch that person grow over time that to wait between week to week to go see, okay, what's going to happen next week, you know, I think it does make it harder because people want it, they want it now and they want it all, and that's available. So it does make it, I would imagine, harder to figure out how to keep people tuning in and keeping the, you know, especially I think the networks, because they follow that format more, and how to keep people watching. It's totally challenging. You have it on your phone. You have it ever in so many different places that you can entertain yourself or be entertained, I should say. I think it's almost as though they're all miniseries or movies, where I think with some of the, especially the procedurals, it's or like a lot of the network TV, the character development is slower. And, you know, with a sitcom, for example, they don't really change over time. It's like all this stuff happens and they're the same. And people love that. And it's, that's, I think, always going to, there's always going to be a space for that. And, you know, as evidenced by NCIS and procedurals that continue to be super popular, I think there'll always be a space for that. But I do think from a writer's perspective, it might be exciting to work more in the arc that people sit down and they say, okay, in 10 hours, I'll have seen someone go through the journey, like Breaking Bad, you know, the perfect anti-hero. And he went from where, you know the story, but his journey was so satisfying to people because you really got to grow with them. And I think there's something that's really appealing to people about that. And I'm sure for writers is exciting about that because you really get to play around with the truths of human nature. We're all changing all the time, I guess. I mean, hopefully.